it's all about. All my, so on the lending side, top producers are all the producers that receive over 60% of their deals come through their database. 60.
Wow.
Only 40% are new. So, you know, that's what we try to build our business on, is that CRM and database and what we call data mining and yada, yada, yada. So I've been really lucky. So like this year, when I look back, I'll be able to see, but we're running at 87% right now of the deals that we have are referral based. 87%.
Nice.
Yeah. So
is that just you or movement?
That's me. No, that's just me. That's me as my team.
Yes.
Yeah. So it's the best way to build your business, because people are always going to refinance. They're always going to buy homes, and their children are going to buy homes, and their friends are going to buy homes. You know, so it's just one of those 60 degrees of separation. So I'm happy that you guys get to see this. I'm going to watch it later. I got a ton of stuff to do today, but I know they're going to probably record it.
Yeah,
so
I think so too.
I'll be able to see it. I don't think I've actually met you before, have I?
I'm Marianne.
You're Marianne?
I'm not even, I don't even work here. Are you guys Seinfeld fans at all? Because I think,
yeah.
I think of
you're kind of like Elaine right there.
Every time I come in here, I'm like, this is like Kramer working at this place where he doesn't really work at. Like, I don't even really work here.
Oh, that's right.
I just started playing with
him. Yeah, I know. I remember when
every
you
time
were
I
here one
I'm
day.
Like, I don't really work here. I just show up for the gym.
None of us really work here, just so you know that. We all just show up, we hang out, that old thing.
Well, I'm hoping to like just absorb what I hear.
Yeah.
It's also new to me.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it's nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you also. So what made you get into real estate?
We just moved here from West Virginia.
Oh, okay.
Kind of
wow.
Like kind of central area.
Yeah.
We were in the panhandle.
Gotcha.
Yeah, we got closing
so,
today, 400 contracts. So.
Arlington, Virginia every day. I used to do that before I had kids. I worked on Capitol Hill the last time I worked full-time.
Oh, wow.
So when we moved here, like my background's in emergency planning and aviation safety. And I just kind of, I thought about going back in that way.
That's it.
There it is. And with like emergency planning and emergency management, you have to be on. There's
hold on. Kids.
So, yeah.
I love that side of things, and if I
thought you too, me. I'll say you probably left on my own side anyway.
Yeah.
And
so,
you can work on your schedule,
yeah.
Your leisure, take jobs when you want to. And
I've thought about this for a few years.
Yeah.
I'm really happy with the nation, like years ago.
You're like, you know
she
what?
She made me like want to help people.
I tell them all the time. I say, I got a little bad once.
That's me.
I didn't either. I moved here 5 years ago. I knew no one here at all. Well, that's not true.
How did you know that?
A couple of different, I did events all the time. And I went to every network meeting. And then I'm a part of Sinedra, South Metro Denver Resort. So they have over 4,000 employees, and they have over 5,000 employees. And I went there to every event they had, and every Friday for the meeting. And that was really how I branched out. But I didn't go back to the loans until August 2018. That's about the standard for everyone. But there are some shortcuts in getting in, and so we do a lot of tools for newer agents.
Congrats.
Way to go, Kramer.
Hey, how are you?
Good. Oh, I got no complaints. See, I'm a big guy. You expect some talk to me? Come on, I don't have to talk to you. Okay. No, I just came to school with you guys. Just say hello. Because she's going to be doing the whole thing.
This is my post-it.
Oh, is it?
Since I've got one today, I thought I'd get to it, right?
So is she going to be here in person? She's right there. Oh, I thought she was going to be here in person.
I thank God every day.
Well, you guys enjoy. All right. This is going to be recorded, right? Yeah.
Okay. I don't need nobody else. I'd wanna be me too. I'd wanna be me too. I'd wanna be me. If I was you, I'd wanna be me too. I'd
wanna be me too. Yeah, that Kramer episode, that's where you sit down with the guy and the guy tells me, I read your report and you have no business experience whatsoever.
I think it's so cute and I think it's so sweet.
Just close Spotify, yeah. Turn it back. Is it my phone?
Yep.
Nice and toasty. Okay, guys, it is 11 o'clock. We have team meeting, and so we're going to get started. Patrick is out for the week. It is his birthday, so send him all the old man texts you can think of. So just kind of give him a little bit of harassment today. So anyway, I am glad you are here. Our pre-team meeting music is, thought I'd give you a little bit of what that is that today's closing day for me, and that's always my theme song coming out of closings. So that's a lot of fun, right? Yeah, Seamus, you like that song, don't you? Yeah, you did. Well, good. Well, we are glad that you guys are here today. We have a very special guest. Jennie Wolek is here with us today. Yay, Jennie. Just head right there. Woo! And we are going to kind of just turn our team meeting over to her and just pick her brain. Jennie, we're glad you're here today. How are you doing? What's the weather like in Tulsa?
It's cold and wet and blah. How about you guys?
Well, we just got done with some snow and single-digit weather over the weekend.
All right.
Today, we're back in the 40s today. It's nice and sunny. You can see the mountains. I mean, that's all we're looking out, our training window, just a view of the Rockies.
Nice.
Okay. Well, Jennie, we're glad you're here today. I thought maybe we'd just start off. Tell us a little bit about yourself and then your journey from day one in the real estate years to what's going on today in your business.
Oh my gosh. Thank you so much for having me, you guys. I'm so grateful to spend time with you here at your team meeting, and what an honor. I'm Jennie Wolek. I am from Tulsa, Oklahoma. I love Denver. My stepdad's from Denver, so we've made many, many trips over the years to your area, and it's gorgeous and I love it, especially in the summertime. And so I have a team here in Tulsa, Oklahoma. You know, I've actually been in real estate for 20 years. And so I can't really start at the beginning. You guys don't have enough time for all of that. But I have kind of grown to share a lot of my secrets along the way of my growth and journey in real estate. This year, I like saying we have a small and mighty team. And isn't it crazy that in a pandemic, we've doubled in size in our team? We've brought on 5 new team members. All of my career visioning process has happened through Zoom. Many of my team members, I've only met them in person once or twice. And so please know that you can still build a big business inside of a pandemic world. Not that we like to, and hopefully we will get to get into real life again someday. And so as we are looking at that, our production numbers this year, we have already helped over 150 families here in Tulsa. Our whole team now is about the size of 10 people. So we've got 5 agents and then various administrative support as well. And so we've already helped 150 families. That's closed and pending. Which is amazing in this year, right? Last year we helped 145 families, and half our business comes from our database. And then typically another 25 to 30% of our business comes from agent to agent referrals. So thank you guys for being so supportive in our area. Thanks, William, also, who definitely is a supporter of business, and we're so grateful for you. And so over the years, I just have learned a lot, and I've also failed a lot. And so that's a big part of my story, is getting into the business 20 years ago. I was a younger person by a lot, and I didn't know anything about real estate. And really, until I got to Keller Williams, in 2006, 2007, I joined Keller Williams, and I really, everything changed for me because I had always been a learning-based person. I'd always enjoyed school. I enjoyed learning. I wasn't always a great student, but I enjoyed learning. And then I started realizing that I didn't have to go reinvent the wheel, that all of our Keller Williams systems, models, and tools are for everyone to use, and that all of our numbers were shared. So there wasn't this uneven playing field. We all have the same opportunity, and it's just whether you chose to take that opportunity or not. And, you know, right when I joined Keller Williams, my daughter was in my belly. And so for my first few years, I was really a full-time mom, part-time agent. And so in that, those times when finally I'd get a little bit of a break where I'd take her to mommy's day out, or she finally started getting into some school consistently, was when I started plugging into all the trainings and classes and teachings that this company offers. And that's really when things changed for me in my life. So, you know, taking Bold for the first time was definitely a defining moment for me. In 2010, I was a solo agent, and I had helped 23 families that year, had taken Bold at the very end of 2010. And then 2011 production ended up doubling my production, all because of by taking Bold, which was, you guys have probably taken it. If you haven't, you should. It just helped change my mindset. It provided me with tools and scripts and accountability. And that was all I needed in my life to just change my whole trajectory of success. And so ever since, I've taken Bold a total of 18 times. And I see a lot of value in that, whether it's Bold, whether it's some other trainings or events, make sure that you're growing yourself all of the time. And it's great to take all these virtual trainings like you guys have seen thrown at us during this year of, I mean, I'm sure you have Zoom fatigue like I do many days. And it's awesome to learn. And then you got to make sure that you're putting it in action to earn. So it's great to learn. You got to get into action so that you can earn. And I don't know how your world has been, probably similar to mine and everyone else's across the country, which means inventory is low, stress is high, interest rates are still low, people still want to buy, but they can't find anything to buy. And that makes for a market of chaos and crazy. Is that how you guys are feeling right now? Still chaos and crazy with inventory and all that stuff? Yeah. So really, I just, you know, I'm here for you guys. We can talk through any specific strategies that you want to hit on. You guys just tell me where you want this day to go.
Well, I'm going to start with the first question. You were talking about making that transition from a single agent to a team. What finally clicked and you with either with your mindset or in your business that made you realize, hey, I can do more, yet this is going to be my next step?
Well, I don't know if it's sexy or a cool story to tell, but when you double your production in 1 year, by not spending any more money, only making phone calls and talking to people and just changing your mindset around, instead of I'm bugging people, to I'm good at helping people. And when I make phone calls and get to catch up with old friends or new friends, I'm simply helping them. And you all of a sudden have more than you can handle in a day. That's when you build a team. And that's where I was. I knew that I was out of balance with being, you know, a mom and a wife, and I was working crazy hours. So as soon as you feel like you are shaking and you are about to have a breakdown, remember that's just right before a breakthrough. So that's when you bring leverage into your life. That's when you have some kind of person or tool or technology that can help relieve some of that stress. And it usually starts with an admin role, and it should. That's what Gary tells us in The Millionaire Real Estate Agent. Now, the truth is, and what I've seen from all you guys that I've talked to, is it's amazing to dream and think that you are going to be a solo agent who is busy enough to build a team, and you're going to have the time to slow down, to take people, to attract enough great people who then you take through the career visioning process, which takes a lot of time, and you're going to find that perfect number one A plus rock star admin on your first shot. It's most likely not going to happen. And how it happened for me was that I had a friend. She saw my stress on my face and said, "How can I help you?" And she was at a changing point in her life, and she went out and got a real estate license and helped me. Was she the right fit for the role that I needed? No way. Did she help relieve a little bit of stress? Yes. And that was enough relief of stress that I could keep growing and helping more families. And then as you keep doing that, you get people in the right roles. You get people, you learn how to be a better leader over time. And then you get the right people in the world that finally you look up and you go, wow, this is actually fun. I'm not still carrying the burden of all of this responsibility on myself, because we know there's 1,000 things inside of a real estate transaction. And if you're the solo agent, you're carrying all of those, right? You're wearing all those hats. And just by taking off 5 hats at a time, you're going to relieve some stress and you're going to give better service. So for me, it was never about like, hey, I'm going to build a team and I'm going to crush the faces off the real estate market in Tulsa, Oklahoma. It was, I need to breathe. I need to not drink so much wine at night because I'm too stressed out. Just saying, you all know what I'm saying. And so I had to get to a point of not hating people, because I was getting to the point of hating people. And this isn't the profession where you should hate people. You should really love people, because they allow us to do an amazing, they allow us to have an amazing career. So I think you're going to just have to know that it's okay to fail the first few times. And even if it's an in-office transaction coordinator, nowadays, when I started building a team, these weren't around, but nowadays the beauty of virtual assistants, I've used a company called Upwork, UPWRK.com, Upwork, and they have amazing freelance professionals. You just put in administrative assistant, you tell them what you're willing to pay, you put in the job description. If you don't know the job description, take one day of your life and have a notepad. And every time you are doing a task that you know you should not be doing, write that down. And then whenever you are doing a task that you know that you don't like doing, write that down. And now you have the job description of your first hire, of your admin. A lot of the stuff that's taking up a lot of your time and a lot of your thought is things like MLS data entry and making a flyer and posting on social media. And all of that can be trained and passed on to somebody else. I know you guys think you're the best at it, but get over it. Because even if somebody else could do 80% of what you are doing, that's better than you. You need to go there. You need to get there. Another quick, easy way to start building your future for hiring is, we all have these phones. Nowadays, we have Zoom on our computers. When you have something that you're doing a task of, and you know that that's an admin task, just go ahead and turn on your Zoom, share your screen, and talk through how you add this property to MLS. And now you're creating a content library and training library for your next hire or the person that you want to do this job. You simply send them the video and they start doing it. I didn't have all these in my early days, so I'm super excited for those of you who do have hiring on your mind. So that was a really long answer to the point of you got to have your mindset right around the fact that you can't do it all. And the number one thing is your clients. Yes, they love you. It's true. They do love you and you're amazing. And they do not care if you have an amazing partner or team member that can help them at the same or better level than you can, because you're too stressed out. You're too spread thin. Just let somebody else who's better at that task do it for you. And they're going to really just care about, they're really caring about the service that you provide, the way you make them feel, the experience that you give, and not just you as the person. Sorry.
Oh, that's great. And especially I love the idea of just take your phone and record yourself giving yourself instructions on going through it. Because even for single agents, our listing progress or process can be different from time to time. Like, oh, what did I do last time? What did I do last time? So start recording now what you're doing.
I love it.
And have it as a great go-to. That's awesome. Thank you, Jennie.
Yeah.
Okay. I want to talk about something else around, and this could be another mindset piece, but you have mentioned and you've talked this way for years, is that when you are selling homes, it's you're helping families. I know many agents, they keep track of this is how many units, this is my volume, this is houses, and you speak at it in a different way, helping families. Where did that come from, and what does that mean to you and for your team?
Well, I don't know where I learned that originally, and it's just so true. I mean, when I say that we have the opportunity to help families, doesn't that have more of an emotional connection to it than the number of units I'm going to grind out this year? I mean, come on, guys. Like, we are in the most amazing line of work where we get to help people through a life event. And every single one of these life events has emotions around it. It could be a really exciting emotion, like a new baby, a new marriage. It could be a very sad life event, like the death of somebody or a divorce. And we are trusted with this very big life event. And yes, we get paid to do it, and we have to tread lightly on their feelings and their emotions. So for us, it is just, you know, we came up with a motto that we chant all the time still. And it's just, this is what it is. Help more, give back, have fun, live large. And so for us, that's always what, help more. We want to help more families, because when we help more families, we get to deliver on our mission and our promise to help our community. We want to give back. Giving back is a big part of who we are, whether it's your time, your volunteering time, or your money. Giving back or promoting local businesses, that's giving back to your community. We want to also then have fun. Fun is always going to be a part of our business. We have to have fun while we're doing this. It's a stressful career path that we've all chosen, and it's a beautiful one as well. And then lastly, live large. Anything you've ever read from Gary Keller, he always is going to start with understanding and knowing your big why and your mission for life, and always knowing that we have to have such a big mission and a purpose that drives our productivity, and it drives the activities that we do to help people. And when we do all of those, we get the opportunity to live a great big life. And whether that's you as the agent, that's you being a leader of your own team, a leader in your market center, you are a role model because others are watching you and they see the amazing life that you're leading and they want to be a part of that.
That's great. You had mentioned earlier that your agent-to-agent referral business has been a new large percentage of your team's business. Before we get there though, I want to go back to that other side, your database. What have you done? What are you doing now that's different than what you started with your database to continue to keep that business and those opportunities to help families going?
Yeah, great question. And I think that we all know the things we should be doing. We've taken the classes or seen the Zooms and the trainings on the touches, the 36 touch system that we talk about all the time. And can you make them a system? Basically, I love thinking of it like this. At the beginning of the year, before the year starts, right now actually, need to be planning out your 2021 calendar. And what that calendar needs to have in it are different events and different marketing plans and touches. And so when January 1st gets here, you don't have to go, oh crap, what am I doing this year? It's already created. The plan is already set in stone. It doesn't have to be, you know, written with Sharpie. It could be in pencil because maybe dates need to change or times need to change, but it's there already. So on January 1, you just run the play. The plan's already there. You run the play. And so for us, we started over the past few years is the times that we've just started having client events. And we started really small because I'm that kind of behavioral style. I want to test it out and try it out and see what works. And then the next time we can make it bigger and next time we make it bigger. And well, this year happened and all of our events got canceled, right? Guess what? We still have just as many Sphere referrals and repeat clients this year as we had last year. So obviously we didn't need to necessarily have an in-person event. We just needed to make them still feel connected to us. So how we've done that are these new virtual ways of having events. So whether it's you've probably heard of a reverse bold 100, that's where you have a big giveaway, something that's inspiring enough that people want to call in for, and on a certain day, you know, you promote it, you have emails, you have videos, you have social media, all the normal touches that you have before you'd have a client event. And then you have a day where everyone needs to call into you. And then you are tracking those, you're getting in all those contacts. And then you're asking them some questions when they call in. So the questions that we ask are, hey, this is so exciting. Thanks for calling in to win the big green egg. So before I get you registered, I just need to confirm your contact information. Let me make sure, what's your name? What's your email? What's your phone number? What's your home address? Perfect. I'm going to get you into the drawing. Oh, wait. And if you can think of anybody who may need to buy or sell a home that we can reach out to, then I can put you in the drawing twice. Can you think of anybody who may need some real estate help? And you stop talking. It's amazing how many people will throw their friends or their family under the bus to get in a drawing, to get into the drawing twice. And so doing things like that have been a creative way for us to still engage with our database, to still have fun with them, and our P&L, our budget, our bottom line really has appreciated this year because we've gotten to be more efficient while delivering just as much of an impact for our people. So our database, another thing I changed that all of you should implement is I had always had a goal, and a part of our mission is that we will promote local businesses. And how I was doing that in the past was I was either going to the local business and doing a video interview with them, or I was going to a local restaurant and featuring the local restaurant, interviewing the chef or the owner. And that's great. And it also took a lot of time. It took a lot of coordination of the videographer and the person and me. And I was never nailing it. It was very scattered and it wasn't consistent. And guess what happens with COVID? Early days, especially, right? Restaurants were closed down. It was really tough for those people. Local businesses were suffering, and same with nonprofits. And so I used that time of being trapped in my house to connect with people either through Facebook or friends or database, saying, who has a local business that I can help promote? And all I did, guys, was I created a Calendly. You know what Calendly is? Calendly.com. I created a little account for free, and I set up when I was available to do, you know, in these 15-minute slots. And I shared with people, and I had to come from contribution, right? I say, hey, I'm Jenny. I love promoting local businesses or nonprofits or restaurants, and I would love to feature you and just hear, you know, how you're getting through these tough times or how you've shifted during these new days and how we can help you. That was my script early on. And so everybody said yes. If you want to go to Tulsa Looks Good on You, I have a Facebook page called Tulsa Looks Good on You, and then also on our YouTube channel, The Wolek Group, W-O-L-E-K, you can search for the playlist that says Tulsa Looks Good on You. So you can get ideas of who to talk to. I really was talking to anybody who would do it with me. And then they'd sign up on Calendly. So by doing the Calendly, signing up there, I'm requiring that they give me their name, their phone number, their email, their home address. So I've gathered all their contact information. and then I'm going to do a video with them. So all I do is I send them a Zoom link, just like how we see ourselves here all the time in gallery view. So I'm side by side with them and I say, hey, Tulsa looks so good on you. And it also looks so great on Bob Smith. Bob, you own the local restaurant, blah, blah, blah. And I want to hear a little bit about you and how you're handling these new days. And I just do a 3 to 5 minute interview. And they are so grateful. They are so grateful. I share that. I save the Zoom video. I put it on YouTube. I put it on Facebook. It gets shared with our database. And they are so appreciative that in these hard times, people are, you know, clicking and learning. And, you know, the key here really is what I found to be true is you do want to find people who are kind of outgoing themselves, because then they're going to share it with their network and they're going to share it with their network and all that stuff. So, but at the end of the day, you know, are you going to build, this is a great way that I found to grow my database, to give back to my community and to promote local businesses. And all of those are a part of my business plan, right? That's part of who we are. We want to give back. Did I get off topic?
No. No, it's perfect. And we had you, I kind of talked to you more about the business videos several months back. That's been one of my favorite R&D projects for the year. Myself, doing those similar things, just sending out some invites and starting to do quick videos with some local business partners. And what a great opportunity, you know, instead of just going through Yellow Pages, just now you can see all these businesses on Facebook as well. And just send them these invite links through messengers and connect. And I think the most important thing, Jennie, that you said in there is what can we do to promote you, especially during COVID times? Because I know every state's different, every city's different, every county's different. And some of these businesses have to change the way they operate week by week. So what can we do to keep helping them? I think that's a great question. So,
yeah, you bet. I've just found that I am so happy when I get to connect with people. So here's the truth of what we've been through this year, at least for me. I've been in my home mostly. Our team, although there's 10 of us now, we are not going to the office. I've seen my whole team all together 2 times since March. So we can still be connected and productive without seeing each other in person and being as safe as possible for each other and for our clients. And so I'm sitting around my house sometimes all alone and getting a little mopey and down. I mean, it's gross outside, right? It's been raining the past 2 days. And as soon as I then get connected through Zoom and see your smiling faces or talk to a business owner and learn a little bit about them, even if it's in a short period of time, my energy level goes up. I have enthusiasm, and then I can share that, because that I feel like is our gift. We have the most amazing life and the most amazing career of helping people, and we've got to be telling people about it and what we can do.
Well, great. Well, I could keep asking questions, but I'm going to share, which I don't want to do, but I will. So anybody else, what questions do you have for Jennie while we have her for at least another almost half hour? What other questions do you have? Put them up in the chat. I'll try to read them off or in the room here. See wheels turning.
Well, we can talk about, while they're thinking of things, you guys make a list. We can talk about how I kind of started growing an agent-to-agent database. And where that all came from was a really long time ago when I first got into real estate, I worked for a different company. And in order to receive referrals from the relocation company, because it was a national franchise, I had to learn how to give referrals. So we called those inbound and outbound. So I always had my brain turned on to the thinking about people live outside of my city. Well, here's a perfect example. You guys are in Denver. I'm in Tulsa. I have family in Denver. So I have a grandmother actually that's in Denver. And when it came time for me to her to sell her house, what did I need in Denver? An agent. Well, who did I think of? A MAPS coach who I had met, when I thought of a guy that I had met while traveling and training at a Keller Williams event. And so I referred her to that agent. Now, this was years ago. And then later on, that guy ended up being my MAPS coach. I don't know if you guys ever heard of Joe Bogar. He was my MAPS coach. But I had referred him my grandmother. So I had always been thinking about, we always have these relationships and friends outside of our own city. Do they know that you can help them? So that's the first step. Start with your friends and family that live outside of your city and making sure that they know that you can help them and their friends hook up with a great agent in their area. So there's one step. The second step is getting really strategic and knowing, where do people move to and from in your area? Do you guys know that? Do you know the strategy? Do you know, are people moving from Denver to California or California to Denver? I don't know where your migration map goes. Here in Tulsa, our main areas are going to be to Dallas, to Houston. Ours is a lot of oil and gas. And then even some Northwest Arkansas, so some Fayetteville, Arkansas kind of areas. So wouldn't it make sense if I'm starting from scratch on this agent-to-agent referral database building network that I would start with people that would likely have people moving to and from my cities? So you could do that through going into command and, you know, following and connecting with agents in certain areas. So you're already connected there. You can go on Facebook. You could search the, you know, the Google. You could find agents in different areas and say a very simple script. You know, hey, Leslie, it's Jenny in Tulsa, Oklahoma. You know, lots of times people are moving from my city to your city. And so I was just wondering, do you have a referral partner here in the Tulsa market? I mean, that's a really direct way to ask to be partners with somebody. A more indirect way is just to say, hey, it's Jenny in Tulsa, Oklahoma with Keller Williams Realty. You know, a lot of times people are moving from my area to your area. And so I was just kind of curious, you know, how is business in your area? How's life? And then you're just forming a friendship and a relationship with an agent. Of course, there's Facebook, and that's how you guys are going to stay connected even better. And you're just going to be building a network of people who become your friends and your raving fans. And then you get to build your own tribe so that when people start asking for referrals, whether it's in your market center or on one of those Facebook groups, that they'll think of you because they know you and they respect you or they've used you. So that's really where I've grown. And this did grow and has grown year after year because I used to travel when we traveled to the family reunions, the mega camps, the masterminds, and it's just showing up for trainings outside of your market and being in and getting uncomfortable and seeing and meeting new people. I think that's super important. Another thing that I did about 4 years ago was I created a Facebook group that's just for real estate agents called Your Journey with Jenny. And so in that closed group, I just started sharing all the things that we're using in our business. So all the checklists and the systems and the tools that we use. And I want you guys, like, it's my mission to give back and empower real estate agents, because I don't want you to take 20 years to figure out what I'm still figuring out. I want to just help you get there faster. So that's where I have a closed Facebook group. And now I've been creating some classes and workshops too. So there you go. And adding value is key, making sure you're adding value to your agent referral partners.
That's a great idea. And speaking about Facebook groups, that's kind of one of the questions that have popped up is how did you start those groups and what those groups are and what are you doing now, or who on your team, what are they doing now to help you maintain those groups?
Well, the honest truth is that in 2017, we read the book Perk Your Sphere by Liz Johnson. It's a 40-pager. You can find it on Amazon. And basically, Liz just created a system around how you can get more business out of your database. And I love the idea. And then I looked and found inside of this book, maybe you guys have seen this one before, And then I, you know, I read Liz's book and I'm like, oh my gosh, on page 141, Gary created an allied resource referral generating program. Looky there. Gary had already created it for us. So he tells us how to build a system for your raving fans, your allied resources. So that's what we did. We created this plan and we started, we got real clear on who are our raving fans. Who are the people that are our cheerleaders and the ones that support us and are always going to pass our names along. And so that list really got to only be like 100 people at the end of the day. And so when you get real clear on who you want to focus on, if you only had a short period of time of people to call, call those people, because they've already proven that they're going to support you and share you with friends and family. So we created a Facebook group for them that's a private group. And honestly, we don't get tons of engagement in there. So that's where, you know, I think that's a challenge is how can you share engaging content that gets them to always want to participate as well in this really noisy world, right? So as much as I'd love to say that it's super engaged all the time, it's not. And we still keep getting referrals and reviews from all those people. So they're still seeing it. They're still feeling it. It's just another form of touches that are thrown at them, whether it's video emails in their inbox, group, you know, text messages or other kinds of posts and things. So the main group that I do engage in the most would definitely be Your Journey with Jennie. And it's because I have a captive engaged audience called real estate agents, because you guys do want to learn and grow every day and you do want to connect with others. And so you're already built for engagement like that. So that's what I got there.
Any other questions? Yeah, Kristen.
So with your allied resources, like closed Facebook group, do you make it to where like in certain areas, there's like maybe only one agent allowed from that area, so there's not this crazy competition, or are you just open up to whoever wants to be there?
Our VIP rockstar group locally are our past clients and allied resources, meaning like local business partners and things like that. In my closed group that's for real estate agents, it's open to all people, even people in my local, even real estate agents in my local market.
And again, your reason for that one being open is just giving more opportunity for sharing and for growth and motivation with each other on a daily basis.
Right. It's not a referral group.
Cool. Anybody else? Do you have one, Madison?
That's just good stuff. I'm just processing it all.
Well, if you guys don't have anything, I'll come up with another topic. So I think that what happens a lot of times for us in this business and in life is that we naturally are good at helping people and we just, you know, go through the motions. And if you've heard of the six personal perspectives, this is one of my favorite things to teach. And one of those perspectives is going from E to P. And that means going from entrepreneurial to purposeful. And so I truly believe that everything we do in our business is important and should it all be treated equally? And usually it shouldn't. So how do you get really clear on what does matter most? And to me, it's going to always start with understanding and knowing your mission and your purpose for life. Now that's getting kind of big and overwhelming, but I think that so many of us get to a point of burnout with people because a low appraisal comes in or lots of repairs come up and it's very stressful and you get to have the conversation with that really emotional buyer and things are just not going the way as planned. And we can get really stressed out and carry it all on our shoulders. And then if we just know that when we get to help that family get to the closing table and we get to earn a commission, that that commission money has a purpose. And that purpose is dot, dot, dot. And that purpose is either going towards your mission, it's going to funding your family's life, it's going to fund your family's next vacation. You have to know where that money is going and why it's going there, because then you're going to be able to get up the phone up tomorrow and pick up the phone and call people that you know or don't know, even when you don't want to and you're not feeling it, because you know that that phone call could equal an opportunity of helping people through a life event and funding your dreams and your mission. And so for us as a team, years ago in 2013, we had terrible tornadoes nearby in Oklahoma City. And our friends in Moore, Oklahoma, they got just pummeled. And this was the second time, and it was 2013, May 5th. And we, as a team, there was like me and two other people, we said, what can we do to help out our neighbors? Because we care about our friends in our state. And we said, well, what if we just give back $100 from the rest of our closings this year, and we'll tag that money and we'll give it to the relief efforts toward all the damage. I mean, houses were destroyed, families, you know, displaced. And so by the end of the year, we had $4,000 saved up because we'd helped 40 more families. So $4,000 given to a community and your friends and your neighbors is a big chunk of money. $100 per closing is not a big chunk of money. And so as soon as that year ended, we go, oh my gosh, that felt so good. How can we keep this feeling up? How can we keep this going? And so we just came up with the plan of, well, we'll just add this into part of our who we are. And so then it switched to, we named it, we call it, now we have a nonprofit, but you don't have to create a nonprofit. Ours is called Keys to the City. And we just made a theme for it that the purpose of Keys to the City is to give back to our clients' favorite nonprofit. And then we will also use those monies to contribute to training and education and scholarships for young people. And so that has two different categories, and here's why. We wanted to give to our clients' favorite nonprofit because that touches their heart and makes them happy. So the after closing call for me is, hey, Wendy, thank you so much for allowing us to help you buy your house. I'm just so excited. Thanks for allowing us to do what we love. You know, something else we love to do is give back to the community. So we would love to know, who is your favorite local nonprofit that's near and dear to your heart that we can donate to on your behalf? And then they're going to share with me an organization that they love, or they're going to not have an organization. And I'm going to say, oh, that's totally fine. You know, typically, you know, we have, you know, the food bank or animal aid or blah, blah, blah. And you can have like a top three that are popular or whatever. And they can pick one of them. And so they always are taken back by that because of the gesture. And you don't even have to tell them the dollar amount. They don't really care. It's just the act, right? And so then the other piece that I shared with you about the giving back to our youth is because I love helping young people discover their purpose in life, because I took a lot of time. I wasted a lot of time figuring out my own. And so I teach a class called QL for Young Adults. And that's through Gary Keller's nonprofit, KWKC. So if you guys have it in your heart that you love helping young people, or you love young people, or you want them to not waste all the time that you wasted in your 20s, then you can be a QL instructor with us. So all you have to do is go to kwkc.org and find out how you can become an instructor. And all of the things that we teach these young people is everything that comes directly from Quantum Leap, if you've taken that, The One Thing, if you've read that, and The Six Personal Perspectives, which you've probably heard of. So all the tools that you get to use every day because you have plugged into Keller Williams is the stuff that we're teaching young people, giving them these success tools early on. So that's what we do. And so whenever you get to a point where you sell 150 homes, you can share with the world and your database that you allowing us to help you buy and sell homes allows us to give back over $15,000 to the Tulsa area community. So thank you. And they feel like they have a part of that as well. So if you don't have a form of giving in your business, you can create a very simple one.
Quick question for you. Mm-hmm. This is Steve Boyd. Sorry, I look like a Nick Nolte chat, so I'm not turning on my camera. Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Okay, so after 20 plus years of mortgages and real estate business, I have a large database that honestly I've dropped the ball on. I've talked to friends who were old clients and found out they bought homes from someone else. How do you, or what system do you put them back into? How do you integrate them yourself back into their lives, trying to get a database built up of all those people again? What's the best way to reach out to them, I guess?
That is like a 5-day seminar. No, just kidding. Gosh, so many ideas popped in my head. And I think that, well, I have this challenge. I don't know how many, when you say a lot of people, how many are in a poorly tended to database that you have?
Oh, good grief. I mean, if I went back over, if I'm just talking clients over the years, even mortgages 15 years ago, I could probably several hundred at least.
Yeah.
Of those that I haven't even talked to, and same with friends that I've kind of fallen out of touch with.
Yeah, well, you know, this just takes time. Tending any garden takes time. And so I started back in 2016, Joe Bogar was my coach, and I realized that I had this database of people that I was spending equal amounts of time, money, and energy on. When, like you're saying, most of them don't know me, or they've already bought a house with somebody else, or they're not going to use me anyway, or I've dropped the ball on staying in touch with them. And so I personally got to get really purposeful about it and recategorize them. And I started at the beginning. I mean, I used a CRM. So back then it was Top Producer, and they're all in one place. And I started at the beginning. And I went all the way through, and every human got a touch of some form. Or if I saw their name and I cringed, well, they got deleted. Because if I don't want to work with them, then they don't want to work with me. So don't you guys, I mean, I know there's different themes and ideas on this, but don't keep people in your database just because it's a number. If they were terrible to work with, get them out. That's not even worth the energy that you go through with that. But you may need to start at the beginning, and you know who they are. Like, I believe this is something that you, the owner, the leader, you have to do because you remember that person. You could pass this off to an admin, but they don't know them. They don't have your sales skills. They don't have your experience. And Steve, it may be a, hey, it's Jenny, and I have to apologize. I have been really, really bad at staying in touch, and I am so sorry, and I intend to do better. So I'm just calling to catch up. How are you? And you go from there, and then you tag them correctly, or you add a smart plan, action plan to them. And then you do have to make a change. If you're going to call them and tell them you're going to be better, you better be better. So what's your next system after that, right? So a way that we do full-on database touches is we do these events, or we do these giveaways. And people who maybe have never responded to us, it's amazing what people will do for a gift card giveaway. So we just did one recently, and in order to enter to win this contest, they just filled out a Google form. And the Google form requirements were, you guessed it, name, email, phone number, home address. Hey, if you can think of anybody who may need to buy or sell a house, tell us here, and you can get entered in the drawing twice. And now if these people you go and you look and you're like, oh my God, that's Sally Smith that I went to high school with. She's never responded to anything. But now you've got all four pieces of her contact information. Now you have permission to call her and stay in relationship because she raised her hand that she wanted to be in your world. So then to me, that becomes a met relationship. That becomes a true contact. So you got to get creative on all of these different ways to get engagement with your people. I teach a class on all this if you guys want to take it. It's called Mirror My Business.
I was actually going to give you a few minutes here to wrap up and mention that. I had a chance to take it, and I'm R&D-ing everything I can with that. But people love free stuff, and it doesn't necessarily always have to be in this big, expensive free stuff, but it can be a lot of little things as well, and to keep track. Jennie, with that in mind, we've got about 3 minutes to wrap it up. If people want to know more about you or learn more about you, you mentioned the Mirror My Business. Tell us a little bit about that before we let you go.
Yeah, I know you guys are going to, I know what always happens here is you're like, ooh, I like that idea. I like that idea. I like that idea. And honestly, this is why I just created a Facebook group. So if you go into Your Journey with Jennie and you search whatever theme or topic I just shared, most likely I've already shared a system or a video or something that you can just R&D it, take it. It's yours to have. But I realized, like William, that people would just kind of one-off ask me questions about a certain little system or topic. And as you can see, there's no right answer. And there's so much inside of all of these systems and the mindset and the business. And so I've just recently created a workshop that's a 3-hour workshop called Mirror My Business. And it's just a way where I dump all of this on you in a 3-hour period. And then I give you all of the links to my Google Drive. So every system that I share has a checklist or has, a system attached to it. And I give it all to you. So I have four of those coming up, actually, if you're interested. You know, I typically do this time of year because I love it. I think we should all be thinking about next year's business planning. And so maybe you guys have this kind of time blocked in the next couple months to do a business planning clinic or something, but that's exactly what this class really is. It's just me sharing how and all the, what I've learned over the years. Because I told you guys, I don't want you to waste 20 years. Figuring it out like I did. So there you go. Mirror My Business. It's on Eventbrite. I can share that for you guys.
Yeah, please do. And what she's saying is she's tired of me calling her every week asking her a question. So now she just made it a class.
And it's not just you. You're not alone.
I know. You get on stage once at family reunion and then 1,000 people come out of the woodwork. So.
Well, I love it, or I wouldn't be here sharing with you guys. This is what fuels me up. It's what fires me up. And I just appreciate you guys. Let me, if you give me 1 second, I'm going to copy this link over here for you, if you would like. One of these days, we'll figure this Zoom thing out. So there you go. There is just 4 classes set up. This wasn't to necessarily sell tickets to my class, but I'd love for you to join me if you want to, if you got some value out of today.
It's a great value add also, I can attest. Well, Jennie, thank you so much for being with us and joining us via Zoom in Denver.
Stay warm.
Yeah, for you, we took away your lunch hour, so we will leave you alone now. We appreciate it so much. And just wish you the best and continued success, and keep us out here in Denver in mind if you ever travel this way.
I will. I appreciate you guys, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.
Thanks.
See ya.
Bye. Okay, so that's basically all we had for team meeting today.
Can we take that link and copy and put it on the Facebook page?
Go take a picture right now, yeah. Can you know how to do that for you?
Can someone who's online?
Like just copy and paste it
into our Facebook group.
Yeah. Andrea, can you do that, please? Please. Somebody. Yeah, it'll get done. Don't close it right away. So, okay. So that's it. You guys are good to go. I hope you got something out of that. Thank you for stopping by today. Go out there and sell some homes.
Bye, William. Bye, team.
Bye, Leslie.
Right. So,
I will.